Today on the 5-Minute Saltwater Aquarium Guide, we show you how to properly set up flow in a new reef tank. Hey, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv and the 5-Minute Saltwater Aquarium Guide. This is a clear, simplified, and direct path to setting up a first successful reef tank. Today, we're adding flow to these two tanks. Water flow is one of the most critical components of a reef tank. The pros are constantly perfecting, but getting an adequate flow in a first reef tank takes about 5 minutes to get right, and I can guarantee by the end of this video, you'll have the information required to get this right, and flow will not be something holding you back from success. Good water flow has a handful of important roles in the tank, keeps food and waste suspended for filtration to remove, carries important nutrients and elements to the corals, movement transfers fluids within the coral's tissue, turns over the surface of the water, keeping the tank rich with oxygen, and strong currents are a healthy, active environment for fish. Adding flow is as simple as throwing a few pumps called powerheads in the tank. Most have a magnetic coupler, snap them on and plug them in and you're done. Typically one on each side of the tank where they intersect and provide turbulent flow patterns. However, there's so many flow rates and types of powerheads you can get lost in it. There's no need to get lost in all that discussion. Perfection's a journey, but at the start of that journey is just getting a working model up and running. Just to get a lay of the land, there are AC pumps, which are just on all the time, wave makers that can turn those AC pumps on and off to create varied flow patterns, and DC pumps that slowly ramp up and down to create varied flow, and specialty pumps like the Vortex, which keeps the cords out of the tank, or gyres, which are designed for strong currents. All, of course, available at different flow rates and prices. Getting straight to it, with these two tanks and all the corals we talked about adding in episode 8, all we need to be successful is two AC powerheads, one on each side of the tank. On a first tank, cost is almost always a factor. Keeping cost down is a balance of cheap versus reliable. One of the things you'll learn throughout this series is almost everything with the plug is a component of life support for the reef tank, and because of that, reliability is almost always more important than non-essential features. Considering all that, there are some distinct reasons why I recommend the third generation Hydro Corellias for either of these tanks, specifically two of the smaller 1350 gallon per hour models. First, Hydro is essentially the founder of affordable powerheads and flow and reef tanks, and by orders of magnitude, the most popular brand of affordable AC powerheads. They've proven themselves reliable. The unique mounting design allows you to aim them in almost any direction, and the only option we stock which has different mounting caps, which allow you to change the flow pattern from narrow, high velocity to a wider, low velocity pattern and adjustable to different tank sizes and needs. In the case of the 40 breeder, we're going to put one on each end aimed at each other, positioned about a third of the way from the front to the back so the flow goes in front of the rock or aquascape, and then use the narrow flow pattern caps, which will cause more turbulence and keep the fish out. However, on the E170, because it's not as wide of a tank, I would use the Hydro caps, which create the wider flow pattern. That's the starting point, and you can play with the different caps and aiming them in different directions to fit your needs. You can also explore wave makers that turn them on and off for varied flow. With the types of corals that we're going to maintain, wave makers are not a requirement for success, but there's always benefits to varied flow if you want to add a wave maker down the road. With the E170, we're gonna go a slightly different route. This is one of those rare instances where one of the more expensive options with the Ecotech Vortech is actually the number one selling of all the powerheads that we offer, regardless of price, again, for some distinct reasons. It's the only option that keeps the cords out of the tank by magnetically coupling the motor on the outside. No way around it, cords in the tank are undesirable. Maintenance and cleaning them is a 30-second swap of the wet sides. They connect wirelessly with each other to create varied flow patterns out of the box and have a battery backup option to keep the life support running in the event of a power outage. The MP10s are not a traditional starter powerhead and has way more features than required for either of these tanks to be successful, but because Vortex are the number one most popular powerhead, it doesn't make sense to leave them out of the conversation. The MP10s obviously match the clean look of the E170, so that's what we're gonna go with here. That said, don't spend too much time debating either of these because both the Corellia and the Vortex will produce the desired result of a successful reef tank. If you find yourself debating it too heavily, I'd just go with the Corellia, save some cash for something else. Installing the MP10s on the E170 is similar, likely up front about a third of the way, opposing each other, wet sides on the inside, motor magnetically coupled on the outside. Mount the controller box inside the cabinet, couple button presses to wirelessly sync them together, and then select one of the flow patterns. I'd say Reef Crest being the most popular, then use a control knob to adjust the strength of the flow. The right flow rate will be obvious once you get corals into the tank, particularly the types of corals that we're putting in. Just as an additional note, the E170 has what's called a return pump that recirculates water from the front of the tank through the filtration compartment in the back. This is also a good time to install that. Plug it into the Red Sea Power Center and turn it on. These tanks now have flow, and the next step is answering, how do we heat them? The ocean's reefs are much warmer than most of our homes, so we need to fix that, and this is the number one source of equipment-related failures that you can avoid with just a couple simple tips. The entire 5-minute reef guide is always available here, but if you want to skip learning the lessons the hard way with heaters, check out episode 14 right here.